Welcome to the start of my Let's Play for BlueSkies. So it's time to start a new game. Not really, since it's all text. Okay, I guess we're safe. It's all gonna come to an end, how are we safe? I'm assuming you're talking about the world here. Skye. Man. The Dark Riders will come soon. I warn you of the broken wheel. The future no longer holds the serenity which enveloped the world long before peace was a forgotten word. Jeez. Now the cycle of life and death. There seems to be more death than there is birth. And life. But you, Skye. You're a gift with the power of life and renewal. Listen inside your heart. I am whispering. Okay. Can you hear me? They have given you this gift. I will help you. Without question, you will be guided. Can you hear me, Skye? Can you hear me now? Please tell me you can hear me now. I got a bad phone plan. Suppose I shouldn't break the levity of the moment, but seriously, I'm getting tired of this spirit of repeating itself. Skye? Oh my. Rise and shine. Enough sleeping, your friends will be here in a moment. Don't want to miss that treasure hunting you guys have been playing about last week. What time is it? I had a weird dream. It's still 8 in the morning, Skye, and you can tell me about your dream later once you eat breakfast. Oh, okay, Mother. It is the most important meal of the day. Come on. Load. So tell me about your dream, Skye. It felt real, Mother. There were whispers. I can hear a voice. I just felt it was addressing me. I see. Do you remember what it was saying? Not much, but I recall it mentioned something like Dark Riders or some bad thing is going to happen. I also ran ruins around me, but suddenly I lifted my hands up and everything around me became beautiful. The more I try to remember, the more I seem to lose it. Whatever it was, Skye, it sounds deep. You know, son, their old tale is a tale of dreams which predict the future. Who knows, you could have received a prophetic dream. Yeah, prophetic. Don't you know what it means? Oh, now you're mocking us? Okay, fine. We'll try and do that. Yeah, right. It's not gonna be a tale for us, I'm sure. Well, the whole group seems gamed. Trying to make a fourth wall joke here. See the October Heart and Miro, as in the whole gang? That's right. Well, well, speaking of... Oh my. Alright, Skye, all packed. I put all your needs and extra stuff in your bag already. English is a bit messed up in this game. More troubles like last time when you stepped on a poisonous frog. Well, if it was poisonous, he'd have to ingest it. No, if it was venomous, I'd understand, but... Plus, wouldn't he be wearing shoes? Or does this guy go barefoot? And what's with all the laughing? Well, good morning, October. Glad you guys came earlier than expected. Whatever. What's with the repeated highs here? Stop rolling your eyes and smack him. They're waiting already now. Hurry up. You're slowing us down, hero. Yeah, we established that. Sleepyhead doesn't describe it, but I'm surprised we have a bunny girl in the party. And notice that how all our companions are female, too. Actually, aside, trust me, Cecilia. Oh my glorious heavens, that was so pathetic, Hart. Whatever. One more unnecessary noise from you guys, and I'm gonna slit your throats. It'd be easier if you just cut out their tongues, then they couldn't talk. You know what, never mind. I approve if you're gonna kill him. And make him shut up. Yes, that'd be great. Really. Yes, really, let's just go. Okay. But if it's already nearby, then Pondon's probably explored it and found all the really rare treasures. I mean, you know, what if some other villagers have already got there a long time ago and dug everything, like, all the stuff our shops are selling. So yeah, of course we know that. We're not dumb. This one is different. Last week a traveler who stayed at the inn saw a shooting star. He said it fell right into Slip's forest heart. Then none of the people here in Suna believed him. And we'll take that golden chance, where everyone's blind. Then venture forth to the center of Slip Forest. Or Sylph, maybe. Oh, interesting. Now I know why you were so eager for us to go there. Why don't you guys set out, like, immediately, then? Why wait a week? Duh. So what are we waiting for? Let's go. Seriously, let's go already. Again with that baby boy stuff? Well, when you grow up here, I'll call you a man. And I guess we can save with the fairy, but... Damn, is this game starting to annoy me with all the talking. I don't know, I don't usually play RPG Maker games for the story, what can I say? Oh, we got some money? I guess we should check out the shop, then. I figured we'd be, like, broke. Darn plants, get out of my way! I'm trapped! What's this? The mayor? Screw the mayor! Ooh, look. An antidote. I guess he's got a point. Somewhat. Ah, shoot. How much do I need for the sword? 230. They spelled Phoenix wrong! Damn, how dare they! Oh, 290? Okay. I want that sword! That was probably a waste of good potions and stuff, but you know what? Screw it. The sword's more important. Oh, and I'm stealing your stuff. Still in my house. Well, we stole his stuff. Of course he's grumpy. That's what you do in RPGs. You go rifling through people's houses. Maybe the mayor's got some stuff. Well, he's got a maid. Here's how it says that isn't really that huge for me to clean. Simple? Are you saying the mayor's dumb? Ouch. Can't read the sign, huh? Okay. Yes, we're here. Now let's go. Ouch. Seriously, I'm your cheerer and source of encouragement. Without me and my guidance, you girls would be down and depressed. Don't you agree with me, Skye? Yeah, of course. Whatever, shut up and get moving. Why would the main character not be able to fight? No, why am I even thinking about this? Oh, great. I hate ATBs. Okay. Besides, I'm sure that the plane girl could do just as much work as he does. In fact, she could have support skills. That's what she would be doing if she's a cheerleader, right? Raise the attackers. Yeah. Raise our fighting character's attack strength. We can do something. Okay. Try and take care of this thing. Just kill it. Bring ya. Death. Great. Darn it. Gotcha. Don't strain yourself there, hero. Okay. A high potion. The fact that our main character is pretty useless is sort of getting annoying to me already. I exist to do absolutely nothing! That's some hero there, right? Seriously, why is he even in the party? He can't fight. Or can we, like, buy him bombs and stuff later? Whatever. Got him. And then we just pound you out of existence. I missed. How could you miss? Oh, and they respawn as soon as you leave the screen. Okay, now I continue our journey. Ah, can't get out of my face. Okay. Got him. Come on. You suck, Skye. Completely worthless. Might as well throw yourself off a cliff with as much use as you have in combat. Here lies the center of the forest. Did you guys hear that? I don't like the sound of it. Can we just go? Somebody's following us. Hello, visitors. Eek! Oh my. It's so nice of you to come here. What in the... She's an unseelie nymph. Be careful, everyone. She keeps with her some dangerous pets. Only appear before humans when a nymph's pet is hungry. How unfortunate for us. Guys, I believe she's approaching. I want you all to meet my babies. Die. Well, let's fight. Take that, harpy. Got her. Great. Sure, I can follow what's going on with the HP down there. Okay. He's on the side of heals anyway. Just die already. Come on! Fall! No, you wanna. Come on, you can't miss those arrows. Death by the mage, huh? Ugh. This cannot be! Oh, that was intense. Hope you're all okay. Yeah, we're fine. Speak for yourself. We almost became snake food. And I almost wet myself. Well, let's proceed now. We should, Skye, after I get a change of clothes. I'm gonna go save first. Better safe than sorry. Shoot. Smack it. Just get out of my way. Come on. Missed me. Brushing trees, whatever that means. Oh well, let's go. Darn it! Got jumped by more cobras! Die, snakes! Die! Why can't I just bring you guys to a crisp? Slash them! Fine, pierce him with an arrow. Whatever works. Okay. It's another one of those unsealing nymphs! Wait. Doesn't look like one. Who are you? Are you the one who fell from the skies? Don't you mean Skye? How you fall through multiple skies? Huh? She left something. Yippee! A treasure! Oh, wow. Seriously, what was that? Somehow rewarded by a creature who fell from the sky? I think we should be careful. It might be a trap. I'm sorry, me be a trap. Agreed. Skye. Wait, I heard something. What, another monster? Seems to be calling. What's going on, Skye? Are you hearing voices? Should I kill you because you're growing crazy? Skye, come here. Embrace this. Skye? Eek! Can you now fight? That'd be helpful. Father, mother, I'm ready now. Kevin, I hope your decisions are final, son. It's a huge world out there, and we do not know what dangers lie ahead of you. Where are that, father, but I know my years of training will be put to good use. Yes, I believe in you, son. I also believe in the heart of the card, so make sure to take a deck with you. I shall be off then, father, mother. I'll bring with me nobody but the tools and knowledge I have absorbed through the wisdom you both showed. That's a weird way of just saying I'm going alone, just taking what you taught me. Okay, moving on. I know I'll learn a lot in this soul-searching journey for independence. I'll not let you down. Make us proud, son. And don't die, I need someone to replace me when I kick the bucket. Farewell. Let's not let my parents and my people down. I must keep in mind why I'm doing this. To become stronger for my parents and our people. Our future. I guess my journey towards the western part of the continent is just starting. Now I must make my way down the mountain path. It's time I truly experienced depending on oneself. Okay. Isn't it dangerous to be around a place like this, sister? Don't be silly, I'm quite capable of for a frail, vulnerable nun. I wield holy magic that could roast your sorry butt right now, but I'll be nice and pretend you didn't insult my strength level. Right. Well, I'm here to aid travelers record their journey. I have an extremely keen observation. That makes no sense whatsoever. Do you know I have extremely keen observation skills? Some even call me the Divine Stalker. Wow, that must be something. Strahd, would you like to save your progress? I am honored for your patronage. So wait, I have to go past her or down? Okay, we have to go this way, but wouldn't it make more sense to ascend with a ladder? Oh, he gets no potions? Poor sucker. This sucks. I'm all alone. Being alone is terrible. Let me at him, let me at him! Death to the Kappa. That's what it is, right? A Kappa? And that's obviously one of Ganondorf's minions. Why are these in this game? I don't know. Apparently Zelda's gotta come over and ruin everything. Or I guess Link would be the one that'd ruin everything, because he would show up and take our place as the main hero. I suppose continuously going down would be a better way of advancing, but screw that. I like wandering around like a lost idiot. It might leave the treasure somewhere. Missed me. Now you gotta kiss me. Actually, don't do that. You got a pig's face. That'd be horrible. I guess I was trying to go like smell like bacon or something, but everyone loves bacon, because bacon's great. This could be a vagabond's lair. I could actually do something about it, but screw that. Actually, helping people by taking out vagabonds would be too much effort for a prince like myself. What's with these waterfalls? Wait, how'd you get here so fast? Called the Divine Stalker for a reason. Well, fair enough then. She really is stalking us. Maybe she's helping me sleep in the nude or something, I don't know. Finally, I've reached the bottom of the western side of this mountain. She is a stalker, after all. It really is tough to spend your venture... Tough to spend venturing the continent alone. Odd sentence. So tiresome. But I must not back down now. Because I am Kaven, Prince of Kamid. I will not back down easily. I seem crazy now screaming here all by myself. Is that so, Prince Kaven? Huh? Who's there? We'll make a huge fortune out of a royal brat like you. People pay good money for royal meat. What do you want? Well, it's simple. I want you to make a choice. You can come with us peacefully, or resist and breathe your last. I think your bones will be good for soup, too. So I usually give in. I'll make a new choice cut out of you. So you resist? I didn't really wish to do this by force. So you mean no choice. Prepare! To what? To die? Haha, taste this. The Fury of Gaia. Truly is something, isn't it? Let's see. Gotcha, sucker. Fear the power of Gaia. Ugh. Because that one... Let's see this. Huff, huff. Either way, I need to be more careful next time. Time to move along. My question is, where do you go now? Okay. I mean, I guess the warp tower would be a good fit. We're trying to get to the Western continent, after all. But it's just at the other side of Ganymede. Many troubles here. Life is already hard as it is here. Oh, he doesn't let you sell stuff to him? Covering the end first before I continue. Come on. Well, that was quite a good night's sleep. Psst. Huh? Nothing around here, aren't you, boy? Yeah. Keep your voice low. You see, there are so many secrets imprisoning this town. Huh? Ever wondered why this village is suffering from huge economic crisis? Well, yeah, of course, it's the mayor's corruption. It must be put to a stop, then. How do you know about that? We haven't talked to hardly anyone, much less anyone that's brought up the mayor being corrupt. Jeez! Anyway, why are you suddenly telling me all this? There's so much more than that. Meet me at the pub later if you wish to discuss this further. How should I know I can trust you? It's up to you, pal, but the lives of the people here are at stake. I'll be waiting at the pub. Well, if he really is sincere about helping this village, then might as well give it a shot. To the pub, then. Is that a broken window? Please heal our livelihoods from scarcity. These I ask of you. Which means this? Ooh, a church. Is there any stuff? Forever cast into this world. Counting on us. What the? Why can we walk into this thing? Ugh. Okay. Ah, jerk, what can I say? Are you walking on the beds? That makes no sense, but whatever, moving on. I'm sure we'll be going there soon enough to kill him. That's his plan, right? Green corruption. Not people suffer while he enjoys a fine life in this place. Whatever. I'm not home yet, huh? Nothing in there. Not even a potion? Someone's got a broken window here. What about you? Do you need a phoenix down? I got one. Okay. Well, if you gambled away, I really can't help you. Good that you're here. I'm kinda short on gold. Not for a drink, tell you what. Know about what's going on in this village. Why people here are suffering, but my information will come with a price. How come you never did anything to help them? You expect a lowly peasant like me to be able to do anything? You seem like the type who's up for a thrill. Oh, so you're just dressed like a samurai because you like the style. Okay, gotcha. Listen, I once worked at the mayor's office, but I quit as soon as I discovered something. And here comes my deal. I'll tell you all about it as soon as you provide another bottle of red wine sweeties for me. Given for free, but fair enough. Nothing's for free nowadays, boy. What is this, fairyland? Now I'm gonna be waiting here patiently until you bring me a chilling potion. Red wine, rather. What, I can sell stuff to this guy? Not to other people? That makes no sense. I like your style. Now, how about you help me finish this? No thanks. Now, about the information. Getting impatient, huh? Very well, then. Have a sit. For everything else, let's get to know each other first. Try here. I'm... Caleb. Right then, Caleb. Let's just keep our voices low. I used to work as a security guard at the mayor's office. All was well, all was good. For me, at least. Oh, so you do know how to fight, and you're just bullshitting me earlier about being a lowly peasant. Screw you. I always stood there with sheer determination of making my life better through this job. Even the daily wink at the counter ladies always gets me going. So what are you up to today, Bob? Just the usual. Stand guard until it's lunch break and sprint right to Lake Serena. Right, that is always you, Bob. Andre, did you know about the reassignments? What about it? Ever since Joe suddenly ran away off his duty and never came back, nobody guards the lower cellars anymore. Yeah? In the list of reassignments, your name is assigned at the lower cellars where Joe used to be. No lower cellar is going to get the best of me. Be honest, it's kind of creepy down there, Troy. Good luck. Where am I to Joe? He must just be imagining things. A little eerie down the lower cellars, and suddenly the mayor was panicking and running down my way. His palin was carrying gold in his hands. Mayor, is everything alright? Yes. Do you have some spare gold with you? Hold on, Mayor. I'll look into my pockets. Faster. Okay, here you go, Mayor. Karis, I sneak to the halls to see what's up down there. What I saw is horrible. An abomination beyond compare. An abomination that apparently eats money. For that, well, I just left and quit the job. No words spoken. So you told anyone about this? No, here's my theory. Mayor is holding down there an abomination that eats gold. The mayor needs to sustain it with gold. That's where all the people's money go. If it isn't sustained with gold as food, it would probably get angry and break loose, destroying this village as we know it. Bad news is, this village is getting low of supplies and gold. Then worst case scenario begins. Don't you mean case? Jeez. Hold on, that's just a theory, right? Well, yeah, a theory that sounds like the truth. Sounds like the truth? What? You ripped me off. I want the bottle back. You're just making all these things up. Hold on to your loincloth now, Kel, my boy. No need to get so upset. No reason to believe me, nor trust me. But I trust you the moment I saw you at the inn. That crest on your sword handle is no ordinary one. I know you're something big. A royalty, perhaps? What? How? You just told us how. You saw the crest on your sword, even though we sold it. And got a new one. So that makes no sense whatsoever, but whatever. It's cool. And through this, I can prove to you that I am worthy of your trust. I won't tell anyone. Prince Kaven. Fine, then. What do you suggest? You know, you picked a bad name to disguise yourself. Kaven the Caleb. Seriously? Well, disguise is still disguise, nevertheless. Even if it sucks balls. Okay, anyway. What I suggest we do is that, if you're willing, we go investigate the mayor's office. I thought you didn't want to get involved. I'm a mercenary now, at least I have a better disguise. Lowly peasant. Whatever. And as a mercenary, I'll do what I am paid for. Rounds were 75 gold, my service is 50 gold. And the information? 25. So I'll come along to the investigation as a hired mercenary. Fair enough. Let's make haste to the mayor's office. Man, I might want to stop and grind here. I don't have that many potions, but definitely don't want to save in case I get killed down there. Of course she has keen eyes. She's a divine stalker, man. She follows people everywhere. Possibly, we'd like to speak with Mayor Fagar. It's about the pub. There seems to be a shortage of stocks. Well, we'd like to address this issue to the mayor, and if possible, talk with him. Hey, the pub's serious matter, to me at least. Mayor, clear and straight, what's with this economic problems in the village? People are suffering. We'd like to inquire, and as Mayor of Grotto, he should do something about this. Or at least some transparency. Well, yeah, that too. Well, I mean, I'm sorry, gentlemen, but I will not tolerate such false accusations saying the mayor isn't doing anything. That in itself is against the law. Then why can't we personally speak with the mayor about this, if he really does care? People here are suffering. Don't you all play blind with me. But enough! We condone such barbaric attitudes here. I don't even know what that means. This dialogue's all messed up here. Calm down, boy. Let's try to negotiate peacefully with them. We don't want any trouble. Wink, wink. Peacefully? After all that's happening in this village? And you call me barbaric? I'm only blunt to what I've observed, and it's true, the people are suffering. Not stop now, I'll have to let the security act on you with force. Just let us speak with the mayor, please. Security, take these two infidels outside by force if need be. Damn, they're coming. Brace yourself, boy. Ah, not enough, eh? Come on. Gotcha. Taste it. I don't have enough energy left for Gaia Fury. Well, I guess he can do it too. Well, his attack involves fire. How could you? We only defended ourselves. You cannot hide things by brutally assaulting your inquirers. Now then, time to proceed to the mayor's office. No! Sorry, Gramps, but we earned it. Well, let's go save real quick, because we beat the crap out of those guards. Now we should go over and pick up some potions, I think. Assuming I can afford some mana potions. Damn it, why does mana water always have to be so expensive in these games? Oh, that's right, you can't sell anything to him. Whatever, take our chances, I guess. I don't want Phoenix down, I want mono water. Guess this is the barracks. No, I don't want to work here. I'm here to basically probably kill the mayor and his pet demon. Let's head to the mayor. What's all that ruckus? Who are you people? I've already instructed them to prevent non-personnel into my office at this time. You're Mayor Figar, correct? Why, yes I am, and who are you to barge into my office? Oh, and you brought along with you a bum who used to work in my office. Watch it, Blob. I am Caleb, a mercenary, and I'm here to address the economical problems of Guado. And bring it to your attention, sir. You can still use a better disguise, you know, but the mercenary thing isn't bad. Shh. What is this? That's a lie. Just another one of those freedom fighters who makes complaints out of anything. Security! We're in the world. Security! Sorry for the inconvenience, but service isn't available at this hour. Merely because your security guards are beaten to a pulp. How does it feel now, huh? Calls go unheard. You savages! Monsters! Hey, it was all self-defense. It's because of the weird paranoia all people in your office have. Sir, can we please have a moment with you now? Why, you... Fine, I guess there's no use hiding it anymore. So you really are hiding something? Didn't have any choice. Just give me time to explain. We're all ears. But make it quick. All I ever wanted was the good for Guado. I want a perfect community for my people to love and enjoy, but I became a victim of my own good intentions. When I started making a deal with a demon... You what? I'll just kill you now, you idiot! Told you so. I looked for an easy way through it all. A shortcut, if you will. All the pressure I was receiving, I made a mistake. I should have practiced a little fortitude. Sir, a king never develops by competition, but through hard work, patience, and care. Hey, an important part of being inspired to do better is to have competition. Idiot. Just like a child, you do not force it to grow immediately, but it grows naturally by itself. Lies. As it is nurtured and loved, you are head-on, mercenary. So that's why I made a fatal mistake that cannot be undone. My grandfather passed away studied enology and was a cultist. I found one of his old tomes at the cellars below, and I found instructions. Instructions that allows you to call forth an entity to give you all of your heart's desires. With all my intentions to make a better place for my people, I did it. I followed what was instructed in the tome. But it was all irreversible. The demon double-crossed me. What do you expect? It's a demon! They lie, they cheat, and they steal. So day and night demands gold. It lives by it. It feeds from the greed felt when it touches gold itself as it devours it. Slowly I've been stealing and corrupting money from my own people. I did protect them, for if I no longer provide gold to the demon, it threatens to destroy Guado. Now what? That was exactly my theory. You heard that, my boy. But yeah, it tends to be quite predictable when you see a city mayor feeding gold to something. I guess. So is there any way we can stop the demon? Only thing the tome dictates that could fully undo it was to slay the demon. I cannot do that, nor can my soldiers. I cannot risk the lives of my people. Because of what I've done. Slaying the demon, huh? Do you know any weaknesses this demon could possibly have? Well, it's not mentioned in the tome, but ancient tales of Vyen talk of a warrior. Or we slay a demon king using the Vyen fusion of Gaz Vienna. Right, because the only hope we'll be holding on to is a child's bedtime story. Wait, Gaz Vienna's temple. So I have my thoughts. Approach the priest, if you will. Wait, hold on a sec. You believe all this, boy? Can't wait to say told you so. Come on, let's go. It's the temple of Vienna. But do be careful. If you ever try to slay the demon, the cells are already infested by its minions. They may have to slay them as well. Let us proceed to the temple. I really don't like the layouts of some of these places. And that's a blessing, you say? That's so, Sir Priest. Gaz whispers you hold within you the purest intentions to rid this world of evil. Gaz's blessings come to those who are chosen by her light. It seems she whispers that the time is right. Oh? Behold, the Gaz has chosen a new warrior to become her sword and shield, to fight for her sons and daughters. You, son, shall be awakened by your divine blessings. Let us all bow down our heads as the ceremony takes place. O Gaz who dwells upon above, heed my call as your son below. Your light which purifies burns the dark, the shadow afterwards turns to light. Bless this, O Vyen of the sun. Bless this newborn warrior to spread the light. Gaz has blessed you. May you forever be guided by divine interventions, warrior of light. Use this power well. I'm speechless. Wow, I can feel the surge of Gosvian's power in my hands. Sir Tri, give me a break. Told you so. Jeez, I believed, okay? It's just a little doubtful. Right, time to slay some demons. Let's proceed to the cellars. We might want to get some levels before we go and do that. Well, I suppose if we kill some of the minions, we might make enough money to buy some potions. What's with all these armors on display anyway? It's really dark here. This is where I used to go on patrol. You don't understand why I quit. Ah, minions! Fight, minions, and die! Hope they're worth good money, because I could use some right now. Victory! Oh, we find more of those. Darn you, freaking bull. I can't touch it! Because it blinded me. Got it. You jerk. Stop spamming blind and fight like a man. Gotcha. Come on, wake up, sleepyhead. Beating the shit out of you. Ugh. Oh, another bowl? Gosh darn it. Okay. Come on, you need to get faster! Shoot! Gotcha! Shoot! Put my best kids to sleep! Didn't work on me, at least. Only barely. Yeah, we attained another level. Let's go head to the inn real quick, and then go pick up some mono water. It helps, you know, to have MP restores and then battles like these. $45G? That's highway robbery, lady. Highway. Can't possibly cost that much to stay at your crappy inn. Always got a better sword than the one we can get here. Okay, gotcha. Okay. That's too far. Probably should go save, too. Okay, moving on. And should I just try and get to the back then? I mean, I have to kill a whole bunch of demons if I want to get a level up. Like, 8 battles down here at least, I think, basically. I'm not sure it's really worth it. Wow, I actually managed to sneak past him. The demons, what are you doing here? Come with us and I shall defend you. Oh, me? Oh, stop flattering me. I'm already committed to the vine, that is. My, my. Slay the demon, warrior of the light. Oh, I can't look at the tomes. It's the demon! This is, my friend, is where all the magic started. Gold. Give it to me! Why are you, Figar? You filthy scum! We're gonna put a stop to you, demon. The light of Gosvian, you shall be vanished! Don't you mean vanquished? Jeez! That was just horrible. And you will threaten Guado no more! Don't you ever say that cursed name, you bastard! I'll destroy you, and all dwellers above. I'll spill the blood of many and spit on your graves. Spit? Couldn't come up with anything better than spit? Man, you're not much for a demon, are you? Told you, stop saying that cursed name. You'll regret this, you little pieces of dirt. Man, this demon's lame. Bring it! Shoot, I defended instead of choosing a target. I need to get rid of this thing. Damn, you try! Come on! Death to the demon! Great, himself. Oh, we got rid of the demons. Okay. Attack. Come on. Oh, that really was a pitiful demon. Life pill. Just die already. Did we just slay the demon? Looks like it. Blessed be God's Vienna. The light has been restored. Since when did you become so religious? My invasion has stopped now. Let's go back to the mayor and report. Wow, this is all happening so fast. All for the safety of the people, sister. I want nothing but the safety of the people, such as yourself. Yeah, if they're willing to pay you. Stop trying to turn the waters where they just won't work. At any rate. You have defeated the demon. You have stopped the demonic infestation that has been ruining the lives of my people for a year now. God's Vienna's mercy. Can we ever repay you, heroes? It's a tough one, Sir Mayor, but seeing this town and its people live normally and happily again? That's payment enough for me. Are you kidding me? We deserve a statue, a monument, a title. Can I spread across the continent the bravery of such warriors? Shall we know in these lands the legendary demon slayers, Caleb and Tribe? Hold on a sec. Caleb? It's okay, Sir Try. Time to come out of that disguise, boy. I'm sorry, disguise. Sir Try? Skye over here, this demon slaying Vienna blessed machine is no one else but Prince Caven of Gemmede. Your one and only heir of Gemmede. I guess there's no stopping this now. The Prince? Your Highness, but. Why aren't you escorted by your royal guards? Yeah, you know what? I never have thought about asking you that, too. Why are you alone, boy? You see, I'm on a journey to better hone myself. If I'm ever going to sit as the next ruler of Gemmede after my father, then I shall have to be strong. Not only that, but just as experienced and knowledgeable, both of the kingdom and Vienna itself. Before that time comes, I must first learn to be independent, hence this journey I've partaken in. Well, there's a drum roll. And a smack to the face. Such strength from the future king. With that, we'll spread your good deeds across the nations, Your Highness. Your name shall be heard among my people. I want you to receive this as a gift of my everlasting gratitude. It's an honor, Sir Mayor. The honor is mine, Your Highness. What's gonna happen to Grotto Village now that the demonic threat is gone? I'll rebuild the village and refund what was lost from the people. I also provide shelter for everyone. All that after I make money circulate in this office once again. Of course, this time the money are going to the people. What about the pub? The pub shall be polished, and I will order new stocks of different drinks for the people's enjoyments. Sweet. Well, Sir Mayor, it's been quite a day. Indeed has, Your Highness. Feel free to stay here at Guado for as long as you like. In service shall be free for you. It's too much, Sir Mayor. Thanks. Yeah, that's true. Now, in heroes, I suppose you need rest. Why don't you both get the relaxation you deserve? I'm in. Of course. Legendary Demon Slayers of Guado, and they're only like level 4 and 3. Truly, that was a difficult demon. Impossible to beat by most people. At any rate. What the? Did it just shake up it there? Oh, let's get the rest we need. Free of charge. Hallelujah. A long day. First, I met the Prince of Gaming himself, made a ruckus at the mayor's office, then slayed a bunch of demons. Well, everything paid off eventually. You're right. What's the plan after all these, old Warrior of Light, Demon Slaying Prince of Gaming? All those titles, I'm gonna have the longest name. Sounds okay to me. Guess we gotta keep going west from here on. My experiences here were rich. I can't wait to add up to that. So the journey never stops, huh? Only until my last breath. Cool. So, sweet dreams. Good night, Sir Try, and thank you. It's nice meeting and knowing you. Same here, boy. Same here. Don't forget to visit here sometimes. I will visit again. So we got, what, two stories running parallel to each other or something? Seems to be in deep sleep. Might as well quietly depart. Only in your dreams. Try, only in your dreams. She doesn't even make any mention of my name. She's like, you can just sleep for free. Go and save. Saving is important. Her giggling's starting to get annoying. What's this even do? Yeah, I'm currently on a journey to hone myself, learn about the outside world, and experience different cultures. Of course, training becomes stronger in the process. What a brave king we'll have in the future. Currently on a low profile, though. Figure I'm attract a lot of danger, should may know I'm traveling alone. I've read a lot about it in books, but sure, go ahead. Warp towers are essential to diehard travelers and adventurers. This very structure we stand on is conducted by arcane energies. The founder of these magical fortresses, Athea, a very intelligent sorceress, or is it Athea, whatever, once practiced a powerful toe-running spell which would allow her to single-handedly take her anywhere her mind desires. After that, she discovered she can actually transport anything and anyone she wants to bring with her. That is by forming an arcane conduct with the very first warp tower, her home. Brilliant. Since she shared these wonderful news to the main magical institutes of Magistra, and she was well praised. As her discovery led to these wonderful arcs that connect people and lands far beyond your reach. That's really amazing. I'd like to try using those. You may, Your Highness, but they come with such a huge price for something which ultimately brings you to your destination effortlessly. A huge price, you say? Price isn't just for business purposes, but it's also a necessity. You'll need to bring with you an Arcstone. Arcstone? Arcstones are rare, but they can still be found with enough determination. Arcstones are necessary to commence the teleportation spell. These are mostly found in secluded areas. for their celestial fragments. Wonderful. Too bad I need to look for those if I want to use this, then. Don't lose hope, Your Highness. I'm sure you'll find some of them along your journey. I sure hope so. Hopefully, if we find one, we can just use it multiple times, because I imagine it'd be a pain in the butt if we had to use one every time we use the towers. Okay, there's a lake. Stores 8 MP. Looks polluted. Whatever, I guess there's nothing here for us. How annoying. Ghastly forest. Still nothing on the signs again. You think I'd try and find out how tough these enemies are, wouldn't you? Okay. Oh, drag. Dude, you can't afford to miss. Damn. Poison hurts. Guess I'm gonna have to go grind out some levels and money to start buying some antidotes and stuff. Dang. Man, these guys are annoying. Come on, take him down. We get touched by another enemy unit, we're gonna be screwed. Let's get out of here. Well, I guess this is as good a stopping point as any. Until next time, then. See ya.